rested. I'm not sleepy. I can do this. Did I end the yeah? Got to do some D. That's what happens when we play Kingdom Hearts 3. No, no, get away from me. How did you hit me? How did you hit me? I know how you hit me. Oh, mother. Come here. Yeah, like, honestly. Ow. I just got an enema with spikes. Wow, I must have been stupid sleepy. Bruh, how did Larxene make this place? The ice that she used was not this plentiful. Not to make a whole freaking labyrinth with all these. Thank you, Donald. Like, dude, come on, son. Did I just surf on my keyblade? Damn. The moment I got it, it switched over. I don't care if you just sitting over here chilling. Y'all talking ish. Oh, I did surf on my keyblade. That's great. And why did I still... Agile claws! Oh, get away from me. Aha, you missed, you little whore. And away we go! Take this. Oh, hello. I wish I'd been standing next to you and did that, because you really use that healing. I saw that coming. But I couldn't really do nothing about it. Now you shall suffer the power of the twin yo-yos! You think I can't F you up with some yo-yos? You don't know how I walk this dog. Okay, I don't think I talked about it in the last episode, because one, it took me 3,000 years to, ugly. Nope. You get away from me. You get away from me. Ooh, Thundara. But, so me and my, I can't remember, so if I'm repeating myself, I'm sorry. So me and my, co-worker was like, MCU did a great job with Endgame and the whole build, like, everything about it. You know what? It's time for me to buy some potions. You know what? I'm just gonna buy in bulk. God dang. F it. Ball out. I can buy 99 potions? Mod card. A membership card you received at the movie store. With this, you will be able to purchase exclusive items. I didn't know that was a thing. Okay. I can buy elixirs now? Dude. I did not know that existed. That's dope. That is dope. Right, Hungry Stone. Hungry Gem. Hungry Crystal. Frost Shard and Writhing Shard can now be poachers at what's called. Oh, I can get the Astrolabe and the Agency Plus. Uh-oh, here we go. Oh, okay. You know, if I can make... I'd rather take the Slayer's Ring. Small boost in strength and a large boost in magic. Magic trick. Draw Ring. Phantom Ring, okay, Cure Converter, okay, you know what, I'm definitely gonna get you, that's it, I'll just go down the list, I'll make everything I can. I'm mad I can't make Skill Ring Plus. I'm missing one Lucid Gem. Just one. Alas. But yeah, the MCU did a great job, but I feel like they might have written themselves into a corner now. Because The Infinity War was a great saga, right? So, there was a lot of wonderful build up for that. What does Cure Converter do? What's my magic at right now? 42? That's not too terrible. Not too terrible. Valorant, another Cure Converter. I don't really need to. What do you got? Damage Siphon? Which, yeah, I kind of like Damage Siphon over Cure Converter. Since Blizzard already got one. Alright, so. And since your boy got hella potion. I ain't finna run out of potions no time soon. You need Slayer, man. That's fine. HP Walker. Okay, so like I said, Infinity Saga was a... Ooh, you get empty haze. Where's your 34? If I give you this, it'll be down 32. That's fine. Sora is the only one that I feel like, okay, even though I'm focusing more on strength, I do like his magic stats too, but he's the only one I like being perfectly balanced. Like with Donner and Goofy, I can have either or.
fine. What do you got now? Defender? Okay, okay. I think we're all good. Well, what I'm trying to say is, like, Infinity Saga was a great start. Like, it spanned multiple movies. Yes, not every movie was based off of it, but, like, every movie had a tie since The Avengers. Hell, technically, since Captain America, the first Avenger. Because that was the first movie that had an actual Infinity Stone in it, even though we didn't know it was an Infinity Stone, the Tesseract. So, yeah, so that one had. So. I mean, and then when you saw. When you see. Watch Thor, they give you the Easter egg of the. What's that gonna call? The Infinity Gauntlet, even though it was a fake gauntlet. Alright, now let me say, because that was a lot of stuff I just did. Oh my gosh. Oh my god. Y'all scared everything to me. So now you must die! 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 So basically, if you want to say since the first event. Oh my god. Since the first Captain America movie, all the way to Endgame. Like, that's a lot of movies, and the fact that, you know. It's like 22 movies in total. So, like, where did Marvel Cinematic Universe go from here? Like, obviously, Spider-Man Far From Home is the next Marvel movie. And the first post-Infinity Saga movie. Oh, wow. I did not know you were the last one. And we are murdering these fools. But, like, what other big story could the MCU do to, like, that will span multiple movies? Because. Like, the Civil War, that was. I'm gonna die. You miss. Civil War was a big Avengers event, but they already covered that in the Captain America Civil War. And that was a Civil War that could only work for how the MCU was set up. and its incarnation now, because like. Oh no. Oh. Stop it. All right. I mean, now that the Fox deal is going through and Marvel has X-Men Fantastic Four back. I guess you could, if you wanted to, you could do a Civil War 2. Maybe. Or maybe a Secret War. That's how you could potentially introduce. Ooh, good-ish, Sora. That's how you could potentially introduce Spider-Man, no, Tom Holland Spider-Man, how he gets Venom. Because in the comic book Secret Wars, how did she make this? Okay, wait before I go there. Got some stuff over here first. Ooh, a ribbon. Ribbon's actually great defensive wise. Look at that. No, hell yeah. Give me this ribbon. There's a ribbon in the sky. Oh, the angel in the sky. Well, no. There's a ribbon in the sky. You're listening to Bun B on the album Two Trill. He has a song called Angel in the Sky that samples Ribbon in the Sky. But yeah, now like I said, like in the comic book Secret War, you know, a whole bunch of Marvel superheroes and villains get taken to this spot to fight it out. I've never actually read Secret War. That would probably actually be a good read. I read Civil War. That was good. Oh. You know what? Nope. Oh my god. They all. Can I die? Yep, I knew it. I saw it coming. I couldn't dodge it. I gotta do all this crap all over again. Yeah, I guess there is an awkward time to find out. In Secret War, somewhere along the line, Spider-Man loses, like, his costume gets ripped, so he has to go. There's a special, I don't know, clothes place, whatever. He finds a different suit, and it becomes his black Spider-Man suit. You know. You know, the iconic black suit, and then... And then later on, come to find out that suit was actually sentient and was a symbiote that will eventually become Venom. Goofy, you have a lot more AP than you need. So I can see how like that you can get Venom in if you want to do it that way. Then again, you also have Sony's version of Venom too, so. Burn you, bitch! Burn you, bitches! Uh-oh. Keep jumping. Keep jumping. And now, King's Flare! Ooh, I am. Still in the thick of it, though. Snake bite! Ooh, I like snake bite. But even then, like Secret War, yeah, you'd have to establish the new X-Men. Fantastic Four. I mean, there's a lot of things Marvel can do. And I feel like they're still gonna have great movies. I'm not worried about that. It's just, I don't, like, it's just, Endgame was that motherfucking movie. Dark Anklet. Ooh, Damascus. Let's leave this hellhole of an ice prison. So, I don't know. Like, I have faith in Marvel, but at this point, I'm cool. They did what they did. Like, when Iron Man first came out, and at the end of it, Nick Fury was like, let me talk to you about the Avengers Initiative. And then the Avengers came around. And then at the end of that,
I think she might have gone up in that direction.
How do you know that? How do you know that?
Come on.
At the end of Avengers, you see Thanos for the first time. And all that, and the setup for that. And now Endgame is here. Yeah, like Marvel has done what they needed to do. You can't tell Marvel shit now. Be honest, I wish DC would be like that. Like, what? Like, Shazam is a great movie. I never thought I would love an Aquaman movie, but Aquaman was great to me. And Wonder Woman was good. Like those are DC's like three best movies. And it's like, I didn't hate. I didn't hate I got the edge. Damn it. Do I got something on everything? Ooh, the literal splash damage. What? I didn't hate Suicide Squad. You know, for the longest, Suicide Squad, I actually enjoyed the hell out of Suicide Squad. But I know it's not a good movie. The movie is not great. It's quite bad. But if you don't look at it, if you just look at it as a purely fun, dumb movie, and you don't try to make sense of it, then it works. Like, I even like Suicide Squad over Wonder Woman. But I will not lie to you and tell you that Wonder Woman is not the superior movie, because it is. Come here, you get hit. But like, Wonder Woman was just a better movie. I don't know. Now, I probably feel like I like Suicide Squad. Only I realize Suicide Squad because of Will Smith and Margot Robbie and Viola Davis. Like, those were the best. Like, those were the best actors in that movie. And they did their roles very well. Especially Viola Davis. Viola Davis. Oh my god, I finally got Leaf Bracer. Oh my god. Everything is now coming together. Everything is coming together. There it is. I can now heal while in the midst of taking damage, and I won't be stopped. Praise him.
Let's see.
I'm gone. Praise him till I'm gone. Praise him till I'm. Oh yes. I forgot this song was in the game. I can't get copyrighted for this, can I? It's not even like the full song. I'll risk it, but whatever. YouTube will definitely tell me if I'm copyrighted. Let it go. I won't let it be known. This bit for her whole life since she was a kid was told to not use her powers, and she was afraid of them. And then And then, like, she was afraid of her powers because she was afraid she was gonna hurt him. So she never learned control of her powers. But the moment she ironically lets go and stops holding it back in, she can now create an ice prison or ice palace. She literally just created life because she just created Olaf. And eventually she'll change her outfit. Like, nobody taught her how to do this. And she, like I just said, she's just spent umpteen years never even trying to use her powers. And then she has clothes beam. All right. Who are you singing for? Obviously for yourself, cause I sing like that too, you know. Are you bored at work? I just buzz out a song. Songs I be singing like almost every time I'm at work.
Wow.
I'm singing past time.
I don't know what we just saw, but wow.
Yeah.
That was Elsa.
She looked different.
And a lot happier too.
Yeah?
Let's say hi.
Please don't
tell
me
you're
spying on her now.
Oh, Larxene! Don't turn this around on us. You're following her.
Ooh, look at you get all sassy. Okay, I'll admit, Elsa is a
person. I love the organization theme.
Maybe
like
she's
this
one of the seven pure lights we need.
It's just so awesome.
Seven hearts. Gotta make sure though. Fortunately, we're in the best position to tell. Can't pick out that special glimmer unless you're standing in the shadows. And maybe Elsa doesn't have it. I mean, just look how icy her palace is. Made of magic she forced herself to keep hidden until now. What if it's dark magic?
Elsa would never rely on the darkness.
I'm glad you know that from a person yet you talked to once.
Depends on how she sees it. If she believes her magic is darkness, that's what it will become. Accepting her power, whatever it is the only way she can set her heart free. So what will Elsa accept? Light or darkness? I know I want to know.
You a hoe.
Well, good for you, but guess what? I won't let her fall to darkness.
It's her choice to make, not yours. You know, I'm starting to understand why she gave you the cold shoulder.
Yeah, unfortunately, it is her choice to make. She's right about that. Why do you keep using... This is like a combination of ice and wind, with a little bit of your own lightning mixed into the mix. Mixed into the mix.
Then stop trying to be her hero. Let her figure things out her own way.
How are you missing? You sure don't miss in a day to fight, you ugly bitch. I'm sorry, I kind of had like PTSD. Bitter flashbacks from that Data fight in Kingdom Hearts 2. God, fighting Larxena. She is definitely one of the hardest. In my opinion, she might be the hardest day to fight. Like, just pure straight fighting. Not with a gimmick like, Demix and Luxurge was. I love Goofy. I really do. He is the hero we deserve. Well, he's the hero we desperately need, but we don't deserve. Who the hell cares? Like, why do we even have to reinforce that rule?
Wait, fellas, do you hear that?
I mean, you're a dog, Goofy, so you got better hearing than all of us. And a snap lunch. Guess Larxena wanted to make sure the job was complete. Oh, goody. Alright, guys. We're going to save this little adventure for the next episode. I hope you guys are enjoying it. We actually made progress. I didn't die too much. I think I died, what, once? We're making progress. Excuse me. Next episode, we are going to deal with these Heartless, and I guarantee you they're going to kill me multiple times. That's just the nature of it. But I got Leaf Bracer now, so withstand combo on Leaf Bracer. Those are two good combinations to have. But anyway, I have been your guy Juice Redeem, and I was tuning out, signing out, whatever out. Peace out. Deuce.